गुड मॉर्निंग. टुडेज टॉपिक इज इट इज़ इन द फिफ्थ सेमिस्टर मेन पेपर द सेकेंड यूनिट जेनेटिक्स. इन दिस वील डिस्कस अबाउट द मेंडल्स लॉस ऑफ इनहेरिटेंस. सो ग्रेगर जॉन मेंडल वॉज रेस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द लॉस ऑफ गवर्निंग इनहेरिटेंस ऑफ ट्रेड्स. ही स्टडीड ऑन पी प्लांट फॉर He studied pea plant. He has selected pea plant for his studies. How these characters are transferred from one generation to another generation, and he postulated three laws according to the data he has received by these experiments. He was an Austrian monk. Austrian monk studied the inheritance of traits in pea plants and developed the laws of inheritance. But his work was not recognized at that time. Later, three of his disciples, they have studied the Sharma, Correns, and Hugo de Vries. They have postulated this Gregor John Mendel's laws of inheritance. He cultivated and tested about 28,000 pea plants. He found that the plants of spring retain the traits of the parents. So Mendel started that physical traits are inherited as particles, or he called them as factors but not genes. Later Johansson named the factors as genes. So he did not know actually the genes, but he called them as particles or factors. So according to him, the trait is any character that can be passed from parent to the offspring. So here, characteristic that hereditary is the passing of traits, that characters from one organism to another organism, the next generation, from the parent to the offspring. The study of the inheritance and variation is called genetics. So this, he has crossed he has selected at least one character at a time, and he concluded by these results and postulated the laws of inheritance. When he selected the only one character, the plants which differ in only in one character, that is called monohybrid cross. It involves only single trait, whether it is the length of the stem or flower, color of the flower, that is called monohybrid cross. In the dihybrid cross, he has selected two traits at a time, along with the strength, length of the stem, as well as the color of the flower, like that. So he has selected the parent and offspring with the help of the checkerboard or Punnett square. He has concluded the results. So there are alleles. The terms which are present in this genetics is alleles. Alleles are nothing but a pair of contrasting characters which governs a particular character. So the length of the stem may be of tall and short. So these two are the genes which are responsible for this length of the stem, either capital T and small t. These two are called alleles. So dominant is the trait which dominates over the other one. So when there are two genes, capital T and small t, so one is dominating the character, other one is recessive. So the one which is expressed is called dominant, other one which is not expressed is called recessive. There are some terms in understanding this genetics, the genotype and phenotype. It is nothing but a genetic constitution of the combinations which are obtained in the next generation. Phenotype is the physical appearance, that is morphological appearance, by which we can recognize whether they are tall and short, like that. So genotype of alleles, whether red color, capital L, yellow color, maybe small l. So all genes occur in pairs. So two alleles affect a characteristic possible combinations are capital R or and capital R, small r. So genotypes may be of two types, capital two capital R's or capital R small r or two small r's. The phenotypic appearance may be red or yellow in color. There is other terms in this one, in genotypic ratios, maybe a homozygous condition, maybe observed or a heterozygous condition. Though it is a tall plant or red color flower, the genotype may be capital R, capital RR, or yellow flower capital R. So they are called homozygous red, homozygous yellow color. Whereas in heterozygous condition, so in the red color, capital R, small r is present. So here, though it is morphologically red in color, it shows the genetic constitution is the alleles which are present in these characteristics is capital R and small r. So Mendel experimented with the pea plant, garden pea plant. So why he has selected this Pisum sativum, pea plant? Because this plant can be grown very easily, and in a small area it can grow, and there are lots of offspring can be obtained from this. So since there is an interbreeding is more, pure plants can be allowed to self-pollinate in a large number for several generation. So it is easy to cross-pollinate these plants. So because of that reason, he has selected this Pisum sativum for his experiments. So generally in a reproduction plant, pollen contains the small male reproductive gametes as formed by the stamen. Ovary contains the egg, so it is found in the ovary. Then when pollen comes and occupies the stigma, it enters through pollination. After pollination, it germinates and enters into the style region. There it reaches the ovary where ovules are present. So if the same pollen is reaching the same flower, that is called self pollination. If pollen of one flower is falling on the flower of another plant, or different flower of the same plant, may be called the cross pollination. So Mendel hand planted, that is flowers using with the help of paint brush. He called strip the stamens. He could strip the stamens. He has taken the stamens, and in which antherlobes are having the pollen grains. So he has self pollinated, covered each flower with a cloth bag, that is called bagging. He traced traits through the several generations. So after he observed what has happened in the next generation. So Mendel produced pure strains by allowing the plants to self-pollinate for several generations to maintain the purity in the particular parent plant. So after that, he has selected two such pure plants for his experiments. So he has selected seven different different characters of pea plant for his experiments. The seed shape, whether round or wrinkled, seed color yellow or green, pod shape smooth or wrinkled, pod color green yellow, seed coat color gray and ring white, flower position axial or terminal, plant height tall and short, flower color purple or white. So he has selected these characters, and every time each one character he has selected mostly, and conducted a cross pollination, and he observed the following experiment, following results. Smooth is dominant, whereas wrinkled is recessive, and the seed color is yellow is dominant over green, and also pod shape is inflated and wrinkled is the recessive one. Pod color is green in color, yellow color is recessive, and also flower color, purple color is dominant over white color. A flower position on the stem or at the tip, maybe in the axillary position, is the dominant one, and the terminal one is recessive, and the stem length tall is dominant one, and dwarf is recessive character. So he experimental results. Results of cross, at the end of the cross, he observed certain results, expected ratio plants producing round wrinkles is 3:1 ratio has obtained the result. So Mendel observed the ratio was 2.96:1. The discrepancy is due to statistical error. The larger the sample, the more the result approximate to the theoretical ratio. So the parental generation, this parent generation is a breeding experiment. In a breeding experiment, the F1 generation is the one where the two plants which differ in their character genetically, they are crossed. The obtained progeny is called F1 generation. It is the first filial generation or first offspring in a breeding experiment. From the breeding individuals from the F generation, if they crossed, the obtained generation is called F2 generation or second filial generation. So cross two pure plant results in all hybrids. So then comes the monohybrid cross. In the monohybrid cross, seed shape is taken as a single character, which is governed by two genes, R and capital R and small r. Capital RR represents the round color, round shape, and small r represents wrinkled shape. When these two plants which are pure in nature, that is the one plant which is purely round shaped seed producing plant is crossed with wrinkled seed producing plant, in the first generation, in the first filial generation, the obtained progeny is all round seed shaped plants only. When they are crossed in the next generation, it has obtained 3:1 ratio of round and wrinkled. So here is the Punnett square or checkerboard, which represents the various types of combinations. Morphologically, three are round seed shaped plants, one is wrinkled seed shaped plants. But there are genetically it is 1:2:1 ratio, because there are two capital R's, and the next in the F1 generation all are red only, but in the next generation, this is the F1 generation Punnett square, but in the next generation the offspring produce 3:1 ratio or 1:2:1 genotypic ratio, because the homozygous dominant is crossed with one homozygous recessive parent. The offsprings are always heterozygous hybrid varieties. When these hybrid heterozygous varieties are crossed when they are crossed again, they produce second generation, the F2 generation, where the dominant species are 3:3 and 1 is recessive parent. Of these three also, one is purely dominant genotype, other two are heterozygous condition. One is pure, this one is the one which shows F2 generation, where the first thing is RR, which is genotypically pure round seed shaped plant. Capital R small r heterozygous round, and small r is homozygous recessive. So these results were obtained at the end of the F2. So this monohybrid cross review, this heterozygous offspring, when it is crossed again with heterozygous one F1 plant, the offspring obtained 25% homozygous dominant, 50% heterozygous condition, and 25% homozygous recessive. The offsprings called F2 generation, the genotypic ratio is 1:2:1, the phenotypic ratio is 3:1, where three plants are round-shaped seed-producing plants. One is the wrinkled seed-producing plant. He has tested, he want to know exactly what is happening by conducting the test cross to know the heterozygous nature of the F1 plant. Mendel then crossed a pure hybrid plant. When he crossed with the pure one with the recessive parent, he obtained the homozygous dominant and heterozygous dominant. There are 1:1 ratio in the test cross, and in the back crossing, he has crossed the heterozygous F1 parent with the dominant parent. So then all are round seed producing plants, but the test cross ratio is 1:2, 2:2, so 1:1 ratio only. So this is the one monohybrid cross, the second filial generation. So we go by these experiments, he has come to a conclusion that after conducting this monohybrid cross, he has come to a conclusion that though there are two genes which are representing a color of the shape of the seed, one is dominant, other one is not expressed in the F1 generation, but in the F2 generation it was expressed, so the ratio obtained was 3:1, and the genotypic ratio is 1:2, 2:1. So he has concluded that the inheritable factors or genes are responsible for all inheritable characteristics. The phenotype is based on genotype. Each trait is based on two genes, one from the mother, other from the father. The true breeding individuals are homozygous in a individual. So from this experiment, he has postulated the law of dominance. When in a cross of parents that are pure for contrasting traits, only one form of the trait will appear in the next generation. All the offsprings will be heterozygous and express only the dominant trait. So, for example, the capital RR parent is crossed with small r, that is pure homozygous dominant parent is crossed with the heterozygous parent. Since capital R gene is dominating over small r gene, the offspring in the F1 generation attains only the round seed producing plants. This is the law of dominance, yellow color and phenotypes. So he has postulated another law, that is law of segregation of gametes. So during the formation of gametes, both the male and female gametes, the two alleles responsible for a trait separate from each other. So the alleles for a trait are then recombined or fertilization producing the genotype of the traits of the offspring. So this is law of segregation. So this is law of segregation in a cross, and the female parent with capital T and small t, one is dominant tall nature, other one is recessive short nature. So heterozygous tall plant. From these two types of gametes are produced due to segregation. So one is the gene which is responsible for the tallness, other gene for responsible for the shortness of the stem. So the male plant again produces heterozygous one, produces capital T and small t. So the genotypes are obtained capital T, capital T, 3:1 ratio, 1:2, 2:1 ratio. So this substantiates the law of segregation of gametes, because if these two are not segregated, they are completely entering into a single gamete, the next progeny will not be like this. So there is a clear proof for this law of segregation of gametes by this cross. So there is one more law, that is law of independent assortment. When two plants are selected for two characters which are different in their two characters, alleles of different traits are distributed to sex cells independently of one another. For example, a pod color and shape. So that a pod color is red, yellow and green. The shape may be round and wrinkled. So round, yellow, green, wrinkled, these two are different characters of a particular two characters. So the two plants which differ for two characters in their two the characters, so when they are crossed, these two characters are independent of each other, so they separate independently the color, the genes responsible for the color and the genes responsible for the shape of the seed also differently entering into the gametes, resulting in the formation of different types of gametes in the dihybrid cross. So he has selected two particular characters which differ in their in the two characters, pea plants. So they say a breeding experiment that tracks the inheritance of two traits, that is called law of independent assortment. It was explained by the dihybrid cross made in the pea plant. Each pair of alleles segregate independently during gamete formation. So this seed shape and seed color, round shape and yellow color is dominant over the green wrinkled shape and green color seeds. When he crossed round and yellow round seed having plants with green wrinkled seed plants, he has obtained first in the F1 generation all round and yellow color seed plants in heterozygous condition. When he has crossed the two F1 plants, he has obtained four different types of gametes, which give rise to 9:3:3:1 ratio of phenotypic ratio, like this. Here round and yellow, round color and yellow, which are dominant characters, they are 9 in number, round green. So the round shape is not always associated with the yellow genes, but associated with the green genes also. So round green is 3, wrinkled yellow 3, wrinkled homozygous recessive are only 1. So this result explains the law of independent assortment. So Mendel's law of parent crosses capital T and small tt, 100% tall in the F1 generation, in the next generation a 3:1 ratio. The segregation of gametes takes place, results in the formation of 75% tall plants and 25% short plants. The law of independent assortment shows 9:3:3:1 ratio by this. There is deviation from this Mendel laws also, that is called incomplete dominance and co-dominance. In incomplete dominance, the snapdragon flower is taken. The white and red color flowers are produced in these plants. The red color is dominant over the white color. When pure red plant is crossed with pure white color plants, so in the F1 generation, all are instead of having red color, pink color is obtained. So this pink color is due to incomplete dominance of the round red color gene. So it appears pink color. So next, when these F1 plants are crossed again in the ratio of 1:2:2:1, one is pure red color, two are pink color, one is pure white color is obtained. So this is an incomplete red one white is crossed. So 3:1 ratio in this one F1 generation. When it is crossed again, it produces 1:2:1. So one is the phenotypic and genotypic ratio is same. One is pure red, two are pink color, one is pure white color. This shows the incomplete dominance of the dominant gene. So there is co-dominance. Two alleles are expressed in heterozygous individuals. So it is studied in the blood group of 1. Type A blood group has genes IAIA or IA small I. Type B or IBIB or IBN small I. Type AB is called IA capital IAIB. Type O is Young's recessive 1. So this is the parent combination. Here the co-dominance is the problem. Here it is explained. The homozygous male with B group, B blood group, is crossed with heterozygous female type A. Then half of them are A, half of them are B. So male O type is with recessive parent is crossed with, so fertilized with the female AB. Then the progeny is heterozygous, that is A group, and homozygous or heterozygous A group is half, and the half of them are homozygous B group, AB group. So they are sex linked traits which are located on the sex chromosomes. X and Y chromosomes. XX genotype is present in females and XY genotype is present in males. Many sex-linked traits carried through X chromosomes. So they are present on the this one is observed in eye color of fruit fly. This is sex-linked inheritance here, where X chromosomes are having eye color. So red-eyed one is dominated by the two RR, and the red-eyed heterozygous condition, white color is recessive, capital small r. So XY is male and XX is female. So this is about